Sebastian from the Metal Gods Meltdown, and I'm joined by
Alex
and Toso
from Atrocity.
It's awesome to be chatting to you today. How pleased are you with Occult 2, and are you getting really impatient waiting for the release in 3 weeks' time?
Awesome,
great. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, because we did a lot of work on the album. We spent a lot of time on all the details, the drums and the guitars especially, which is, for me, very fine. And all the instruments, all the voice especially. I think Alex did a great job with the vocals. Very sharp and precision-wise brutal. So it's a very sharp and tight brutal hit. We're very happy with the result.
You guys research your subjects for every release and makes Atrocity albums more special than run-of-the-mill extreme metal bands. How important is it to you that all your releases have a deep and thoughtful insight?
And for us, it's like a celebration to release a record like the Occult 2 album. It's from a great concept, like a trilogy, the Occult trilogy. And as we don't release a record every year, we are an established band and formed back in 85, first death metal band out of Germany, and all this long musical adventure we're doing in the heavy metal world. So we really love to celebrate every album and give every time the best we have.
You're going to be having a release party?
Yeah, we will play a great and splendid release show at a festival, at the Sandstorm Festival, open air festival here. In our area, and we're very much looking forward to that, of course.
How well does Occult 2 tie in with the first Occult album?
Probably more guitar-oriented than the first album, more riffs, more heavy stuff, a little bit less symphonic. Although we have like all these great horror choirs in there, which was great to record them, by the way. And we also have like some very dark atmospheric parts, which suit very cool to the occult concept, which is about like the dark side of humanity and the mysteries in the world.
It's the one track off the new album that you can say epitomizes what Occult 2 means for Atrocity.
I think there are several tracks which are great. I mean, we released the Masters of Darkness EP, that's also the opener of the Occult 2 album, and here you find actually also all elements of what is about with Atrocity and the Occult trilogy concept. Bludgeon and Triumph is another one stands out for me. And of course, we did now Shadow Taker video clip last weekend, which was great fun. And we recorded the clip underneath a mountain. And it's really, really great, like, 500 meters deep down in the ground and recording in an awesome cave. So, yeah, and a great side story, by the way. A very nice, a dream in red.
Your album covers are always really awesome. Do you have a lot of the artwork around your homes?
Yeah, I mean, that Stefan Heilemann is the graphic designer, and we work with him since several albums, and he's also a cover artist for Camelot, for Epica, also for Leaves Eyes, our other band, and many others. And it's very strong connected now to the title Masters of Darkness, which is about the madness and the occultism in the Third Reich, all this inhuman ideologies, absolute worldview, interpretation of world history, united under the Black Order and the religion of blood, sworn the oath on the blood flag, and we wanted to have a cover artwork, showing this kind of dark army on the cover.
Can you tell us what does 2018 hold in store for Atrocity tour-wise, tour and festival-wise?
Yeah, we will start with the festival at Sandstorm open air, and then there are several offers that we already have, also one for Dubai and other shows, but we also have to coordinate because we're going to do a intense tour in September, October with Camelot and Leaves Ice. So I guess after that tour, you can expect more touring at the end of the year and especially in 2019.
Brilliant. And of course, I'm going to ask, do you think you'll be getting over to the UK at some stage?
Yeah, we hope so very much. I think there are already some plans and there are chances we come to the UK.
Brilliant. So how do you rate the importance of being seen live and meeting fans whenever possible?
Yeah, I think for an extreme metal band, extreme metal for me always works best live in a situation where you have, let's say, 200 or up to 1,000 people. That's like where I think the music can be displayed in the most intense way. And I think you get to know really what a band is about, of course with the album, but like in all aspects if you see them live. So that's very important for us. We love to play live. And yeah, of course it's great to meet the fans. We've been traveling all around the world already. We're not a new band.
No.
We're not 20 anymore. Uh-huh. So we've been in Latin America, Australia, Asia, Belarus, wherever. We've played almost everywhere, and so it's really also a gift being able to be seen everywhere. We have a lot of getting a lot of attention also in countries like Indonesia and Malaysia, also India. So that's really great that heavy metal has become such a worldwide phenomenon.
Yeah, we did also great tours in North America, and yeah, that's gift for a band like Torso said, like Atrocity, being around for such a long time and touring 50, 60 countries, 5 continents. That's like great meeting the metal family out there, and being one of the bands, the people like in Latin America, for example, were able to see us in some countries, not so many other bands going there.
But which 4 tracks would you play me from the band's history to introduce me to Atrocity if I was totally new to extreme metal?
That's a tough decision. Only 4. Wow. Yeah, maybe
Shadow Taker.
from the new album, you could definitely take Shadow Taker. I think that's a good introduction. Then one of the classic Atrocity songs that has been always in the set list when we play is Necropolis.
Rhino Phenomena is also
Rhino
good. Rhino
Phenomena could be also a good track. So it's hard to say.
Maybe from the debut album you can take Deep in Your Subconscious, for example.
Somebody else will say take something from Blitzkraft or from Atlantis.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you.
Schlachthaus, like the people's slaughterhouse. You can interpret it in that way. Describes the real horror of the World War One on the basis of a true story. In 1912, there was already a German teacher, Wilhelm Lamsus. He wrote a book which was called like that. And it's about the Cold War machine, the industry of war, or the modern kind of war. The people had no clue what will come. You know, they were used of war lines, people on horses and stuff like that, like glorious type of war, you know, in the imagination of their heroes dying in a glorious way, which was absolutely not the case. And so, like 2 years later, his dark visions became reality, and he also had to go to war, this teacher. He wrote another book, which was called Das Irrenhaus, The Madhouse. And then, yeah, actually shown all the madness going on in a war like that. And yeah, the people were sent to war by their leaders, and their, yeah, agitation and instigating, you know, with success, actually, from all sides. And hundreds of thousands of people had to die for some meters of land or ground winning on the battlefield in the mud. And yeah, that's about this insanity. It suits very good in that song, especially. Using German language since Todesinz, was the second album in 1992. Uh-huh. So there was no Rammstein yet or something else like that. So yeah, we were kind of pioneering the territory using German language in metal or in death metal. And some people didn't really get it in the beginning. They thought like, wow, are you Nazis? We just use our mother tongue.
Yeah, exactly.
And it suits to extreme metal. There's nothing wrong with that. And yeah, we destroyed swastikas on stage and stuff like that, made political statements even before we used German language in our songs.
Which are your two favourite albums of all time, and what they meant to you personally?
Holy Christ, that's very hard to say. I just picked, let's do it like that. I picked like two ones of my childhood. It was Made in Japan of Deep Purple and The Wall of Pink Floyd. And then I take two of my teenage days. It was like Killers of Iron Maiden. And yeah, Hallowaids of Slayer, of course.
What short phrase best describes the band and its mood right now?
You have that sentence, Der Tod ist ein Meister aus Deutschland, which is from a poem in Germany, Die Todesfuge, which means like death is a master of Germany. Well, in a way, it suits us as well.
Maybe not so much in a political way, but like when you're an extreme metal band.
Yeah, that's what I mean, of course.
And of course. If you come out with a really brutal and such a tight album, it is always a good sign that the band is alive and still vital.
I think brilliant.
That's how it should be.
So can you tell me why we should buy A Cult 2?
I think if people are into extreme metal and death metal with some, you know, atmosphere, and maybe they like also choirs and some symphonic parts, they have the real deal with that album. And on top, they have a great lyrical concept. I always did a lot of researches for, you know, concept albums like Atlantis. And so I thought like the Occult Trilogy would be great because it, you know, it covers up, you know, from very dark and even brutal topics to also places you still can go to feel yourself or make your own experiences, and also like this conspiracy theories around the world. I thought it's very interesting stuff. You don't have to be a history nerd like us or an occultist or something like that to enjoy this metal album. But I think people are going into you know, more depth and music straight in your face at the same time. maybe that album is the right thing for you.
Yeah, and on a spontaneous note, you also have a lot of choruses that you can shout along and riffs that you can maybe remember, so that's also pretty cool.
Do you have any final words for your fans and our listeners?
Of course, we want to thank everyone for the great support. Thank you for this fantastic interview. We would love to come back to the UK. We played there last time on the Occult Tour. So now it's Occult 2, and we hope to be back very soon. This is Alex
and Toso from Atrocity.
And you're listening to
Metal Gods Meltdown. Ugh.